Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So here we'll continue unit number 6 about programming, the structure of programs. Last week we took this structure of program and we have seen three different ways the program executes: sequence, selection, and repetition. I will just have a brief on it and then we'll continue from trace table where we stopped in the last week, and hopefully inshallah today we are going to cover this unit number 6, and you'll have up to here unit number 6 for your midterm exam. The midterm exam is on Monday, right? On 20th of November, on Monday. So that is from unit 1, 2, 3 and 6.
Okay.
Sorry? This is also coming. Today, inshallah, we'll discuss that. What? Unit 1, 2, 3 only? No, I think unit 1, 3 and 2, 1, 2, 3 and 6. Today for M150A. But even I checked today, it was 1, 2, 3, 4, and I mean 1, 2, 3 and 6. We'll check it inshallah, no problem. Fine. So this is about the structure of the program. The aim of this section is to explore the way in which selection, repetition can be achieved in a high-level programming language and introduce you some Boolean operators, that is NOT, AND OR. We have the, in the structure, we have three different structures: select, sequence, selection and repetition. And we took this before, I mean, just an overview of this one, a brief about that, okay. For the most programming language, the default execution is sequential, that is the execution of the program line by line without skipping any part or without repeating any code one after the other, that becomes a sequential execution. We have selection of the statements to execute or the code to execute based on some condition that we have seen in the last class by taking some example. In the same fashion, we have repetition, that is repeating a particular code or a piece of code or some statements based on some condition. Okay, that becomes the repetition. These instructions which change the flow, that is which do some selection or which do some repetition, we call that as in control instructions. We call them as in control instructions. Okay. Now, control instructions are used to support the selection and repetition, and which are two very powerful mechanisms in writing the computer programs. Selection is deciding some code to execute based on some action. So in selection you have single selection or multiple selection, okay. And we also have a repetition, but is repeating some sort of code or a piece of code for a number of times based on some condition. So we have taken these exercises in our last meeting for this selection and repetition and all. Here is an example of selection. If it is snowing, put the cat in the kitchen, else put the cat outside the kitchen, turn out the lights. Now this is a simple example. The condition here, or the control statement here, it is snowing. So if it is snowing, if it is true, then the first statement will be executed, and if the same is false, and if the same is false, then the second statement will be executed. The first will be skipped and the second will be executed, and this is the whole one condition. And after executing this any one of the statement, it comes to execute, turn out the lights. Then the flowchart can be put in this fashion. As you can see, it is snowing. If it is true, put the cat in the kitchen, turn out the lights. If this becomes false, then put the cat outside and turn off the lights. And sometimes it is convenient to put the condition in a negative form by using a not. For example, if the customer not an adult, charge 5 euro, else charge 10 euro. Okay, so here it is, we are using a not condition here. Okay, so for this we have a boolean operator, called not for this thing, for this putting a not condition. This boolean operator is a unary operator which operates on single condition, okay, and it returns the opposite of the result. For example, not of something true is false, and not of something false is true. So the truth table for this can be in this fashion. For example, if A is a condition, and then not of A is what? For example, if A is false, then the not of A is true, and if A is true, not of A is false. This is a truth table for the not, just what we have seen. Now, other selection examples, we can have a multiple selection. This is a single selection. If there is some changes in the document, save it, print the document. There is no else part. Okay, this is a single selection. We can have a selection with multiple conditions. For example, here, if book is fiction, put it on the first shelf, else if book is biography, put it in the second, else put it on the third shelf. So more than one condition we can have. Okay, putting such thing, we call it as a nesting, adding one condition inside another condition, we call it as a nesting the condition, or nesting if, or sometimes we call it as a nested if. Repetition is nothing but a looping which we try to repeat a part of the things, or which is try to repeat a part of the code or some statements based on some condition. For example, here, when there are more pages left to read, read the page, turn the page. Again, after this, go back and check the condition. Okay, so until and unless this condition is true, the body of the loop, this is called the body of the loop, will be executed, and again it will go back and check the condition. Once this become false, then it will come out of the loop. And we have seen in the last class that this condition must become false after some time, after some repetition. This condition must become false. That depends on how many number of pages in this case. For example, in this page, it's not written here. It's just an example. But it need to be, this condition has to become false after some time. Okay, for example, there are 100 pages. After 100 pages, this condition will become false. Has to become false. Otherwise, this loop will be in an infinite loop. This will be an infinite loop. This is what is given here, infinite loop. In designing a loop structure, if care is not taken to ensure that condition become false, then the loop body will repeat forever, and this is called an infinite loop. An infinite loop is always dangerous for the system. Okay, yeah, fine. Here are some activities. For example, you can see this activity, this is a flow chart. Okay, this activity is to check how many times the loop is executed, or the loop body is executed, and what is the loop condition here, what are the statement outside the loop, and what is the output of this flowchart. This type of question you have in your exam, in your midterm exam. They'll give the flowchart and ask you to add these things. Okay, so for example, here the loop body is executed how many number of times? So you can attend that. Okay, I'll give you the recording of this class. Okay.
Thank you.
So set the initial value of count 3. So how we can make a calculation for this is that It's very simple that you need to put in a form of table. You need to put in a form of table. For example, here now how we can put this and how we can calculate that to answer these questions and all. I think this is not the example. Yeah, this one. That was another example. It's okay. Both are same. Fine. You have the code here as in flow chart. Okay. You can put it in a form of table. This one in a form of table to just to calculate. First of all, you have a set the initial value of the count 2, 3. So we have a variable or a word which is called count, whose value is 3. Okay, then it says that it gets in and said not count is 0, not of count is 0. So we have a condition called count is 0, and we need to calculate not of it, not of count is 0. Okay, so if count is 0, we have the value of count. The count is 0 is false because count is 3. So if it is false, then the not is
true.
When it is true, it will get in and execute the body of the loop. So what is the body of the loop? Write out the value of count in the output window. Let's say this is an output window. No, that's not necessarily. If it is not asked to draw the trace table, then no need to draw this table. Okay, if it just asks you to give the output, you just put the output. Okay, this is just for your explanation. Fine. Write the value of count in the output window. Let's say this is an output window. What is the value of count?
3.
So we write 3. Move to the next line. So the cursor will move to the next line, or the pointer will move to the next line. Reduce the count by 1. Reduce by 1, it means minus 1. So count is 3. 3 minus 1?
2.
So the new value of count is
2.
So this is the body of the loop which is executed completely. After executing it completely, it will go back again to test this condition. Count is 0, count is not 0. So this is false, the not of it is
true.
Then if it is true, it gets in again to the body of the loop. So it is repeating again. Then write out the value of count. What is the value of count?
2.
So it will write the value 2 on the output window. Move to the next line, move the pointer to the next line, reduce the count by 1. So 2, reduce it by 1, minus 1, it becomes
1.
Then after this, again it will go back and check the condition. Count is 0, false. Not of false is
2.
Again gets in, write the value of count. Write the value of count, that is 1. Okay. Move to the next line, so we will move to the next line. Reduce by 1, minus 1, now it is 0. Again it will go back and check the condition. Count is 0, it is true. Not of 2 is false. So if it is false, it is now coming out, and what is given? Write blast off. After that, this is the end of the program or end of the flow chart. Okay, so this is the output. How many times the loop is executed?
Three times.
Three times the condition was true and the loop body is executed. Sorry. If it is 6, then it will be executed 6 times. Okay? Every time it is executed, you need to add it 1, 1, 1.
Until it becomes 0?
Until it will become 0. Until this condition becomes false. Okay? So it depends on the condition. So the loop body is executed 3 times. The loop body is executed 3 times. Number one. Number two, what is the loop condition?
Sorry?
What is the loop condition? What is the selection condition here? What is, which statement is the condition here? Which is giving true and false?
Not count is
0. This is the loop condition. Not of count is 0. This is the loop condition, or you can say the condition of the loop which will give true or false, or a Boolean expression. Boolean expression is also called Boolean expression because it will give true or false. Okay, what is the body of the loop? This is the body of the loop.
We have to write code, right?
Yeah, you have to give it. This is the body of the loop. What are the statements outside the loop?
Blast.
Set the initial value to 3 and
blast
off. These are the statements outside the body of the loop. This type of questions you have for your exam. I mean, in the exam, they ask this type of question. Okay? Fine. This is another example with the number value 6. But here, you know, we set the value to 2 and we are incrementing the value by 2. There we reduce it by 1. Hereby we add 2 to number. Starting from 2, then we are writing 2, then add 2 to it. So 2 will become 4. Then again we check the condition. Write 4, add 2 to it. So 2 will become 6. Once it becomes 6, it will false, come out of the right, and write all finished. Okay. Till here, we had taken before, I mean in the last class. Okay. Now the new thing here is called a trace table. What is trace table? What just we took for an explanation, this type of table, we call it as a trace table. Trace, it means that we are tracing or tracking how the changes are going on with the variables, with the count, what is printed, okay, what is the condition, true or false. That we put in a form of table and we write the values in a table. That table we call it as a trace table. Okay. Trace tables are not exactly same for everyone. Someone will have a table different from another one. Different in the sense that the columns and the rows may be different, but the output will be remain the same. The result will remain the same, but someone will just write the value of count. Instead of writing count of 0 and all, directly it will write not of count. Okay, and then directly it will write the output, 3 columns. Someone will write 6 columns by giving more details. Okay, but there is no difference between these. Fine. So it is up to you that how much you want to add more information in the table. So you can see here the trace tables. One way of working out what the program does by using a trace table. You can see the table as an example here. This table is for the previous flowchart, for this flowchart. Okay, so let me put this there. I remove all this one and its trace table is this one. You see, this is the flow chart. Okay, this flow chart that set the number to value to 2 and we check the condition not of number is 6, and this is repeated for 2 times giving the output 2, 4, and then it's coming out and giving all finished and printing all finished. This is put in a form of table as given here. Line being executed. So here it is, which line is executed in the flow chart. Which line is executed? Line number 1, line number 2, or which line is executed. That is given here in this, that line being executed. Okay, this is an optional part. If you want to track the line numbers also, you can write. Otherwise, you can skip this. You can skip this. The first one, line being executed. This is just to give the line number. For example, this is line number 1, this is line number 2, line number 3, 4, 5, line number 6, and so on. Okay? So, line being executed, you can keep it or you can skip it. Just remove it. Don't write it.
Don't write
1
to
6. Yeah, don't write that line, the column line being executed. You can just don't write. You just skip it. Okay. Now the main thing is that the number we keep track of the number, we keep track of the condition, we keep track of what is written in the output window, and we keep track of the number how it is changing, and what is written finally in the output window. So we keep track of number. Initially the number is 2. In the first line we are setting the number is 2. Set the number is 2. Number value 2. Then after this we check the condition. So it is checking the condition. Number is 6. It is false because number is 2. So not of number is 2. This is true. Because it is false, the not of it is true. Now if it is true, it is getting in, write the number on the output window. So this is the output window, for example. So it will write in the output window 2. In the output window it is writing 2. Then after this, move to the next line, add 2 to the number. So it is adding 2 to the number in the line number 5, adding 2 to the number. So the number become from 2 to 4. So after that, again, it will go and check the condition. This condition. Okay? It will go back and check the condition. So again, the condition is false. Not of it is
true.
And then after that, if it is true, it get inside. Inside it, write the value of the number. So it is writing the value 4. Again add 2 to the number, so 6. The condition is true, not of true is false. Then it is writing all finished. This table, if you write this 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 columns, it is enough. This is called a trace table. This is called, he did not get it. Let us
because there's so many spaces and I don't know.
No, you forgot about that. Just have a look in this one. Yeah, that is better, and we'll write it by yourself. Yeah, we'll write the trace table by ourselves. Okay. So this is the flowchart, and you are asked to draw trace table and write the output. The question is, given is a flow chart, you are asked to draw the trace table and draw the output. Okay. Now trace table, it is in a form of table. This is in a form of table. What are the things we need to add in the table? Is the first, we need a number, right? So the value of the number. So we write a number here, number, the value of number. Then we have something, condition, number is 6. So we write number is 6. And then we have not of it. Not of number is 6. And then we have writing the output. Writing the output. So we write output here. Okay. So we have 4 columns here. Now starting from number. Number is 2. The value of number is
2.
After that, it goes and check the condition. Number is 6.
False.
Not of false.
True.
If it is true, what it will do? Write the value of number in the output window. Let's say this is the output. So what is the value of number? 2. So it will write 2. It can be in the same table. We are writing a trace table. Okay. There was no space, so I have added in the last.
Okay. It can be in the
same table. Okay. Fine. So you put 2, that is write the output, move to the next line in the output window, we'll move to the next line, add 2 to the number. Now we are changing the number. So the number becomes
4
plus 2, and then it becomes 4. After it becoming 4, again it's going back and checking the condition. Number is 6,
false,
not a false, true. Write the value of number, it is 4, move to the next line and then add 2 to the number. So again we are adding, it becomes
6.
Now number is 6, it is true, not of true is false. Now if it is false, it's writing all finish. So it will write all finish. This is the trace table, a simple trace table, and this is the output. You can, if you want, you can write separately. After this, you can write separately. Output is 2, 4, all finish. Or it is better you write this, the output, after it. Okay. This is called a trace table. The next, we have something called compound conditions. Compound conditions is nothing but joining two or more conditions. Two or more conditions, we call it as a compound condition. For example, here it is raining or snowing. So here there are two conditions, raining or snowing. So we are joining these two conditions by using an operator OR. By using an OR. Such type of conditions where we have two or more conditions, we call it as a compound condition. And we make compound condition by using the logical operators OR and AND. OR and AND. Now, what is the conditions involving OR? When the conditions have OR, okay, we'll see that to become the whole condition true, what should be the true? And to become the whole condition false, what should be the false? For example, I have two conditions. It is snowing or it is raining. This is one condition. If it is snowing or it is raining. Let's say it is snowing is A and it is raining is B. So it is like A or
B.
Now this whole condition to become true, what should be true in these two conditions? Or this whole condition to become false, what should be false? So we will see that in a form of truth table. As you can see, there we have two conditions A and B, and we have the compound condition A or B. In the OR operator, if both or any one is true, if any one or both is true, then the result is also true. If both are false, then the result is false. Or you can say that if both are false, it is false, otherwise it is true. Otherwise it is true. It can be anything. For example, let's say it is raining, it is not snowing. So it is snowing is false or raining is true. So in the OR condition, if any one is true, the whole condition is true. Because it is an OR condition, either this or this. Okay? So if any one is true, it is true. Or if both are true, it is
true.
In only one condition, if both are false, then the whole condition become
false.
Okay? This is an OR. Fine. We have some examples here. You can see these two examples. The shape is circle, the shape is filled in by color. Okay? If both are true, it is true. If both are false, it is false. If false, true, 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 false, true. So simple OR. We have AND. The AND is just opposite. If both are true, it is true, otherwise it is false. Because it is an AND condition, both conditions should satisfy. For example, if it is snowing and it is raining. If both are true, the whole AND, it is true. If any one false or both are false, it is
false.
So you can see that in the truth table. If both are true, it is true. Otherwise, it is
false.
Okay, this is an AND operator. This is also a binary operator. These are two examples for AND operator. Precedence rule, that while we are using AND and OR, okay, which should be executed first and which should not be. The first thing is the parenthesis, then the second thing is the unary operator, that is NOT, and the third thing is a binary operator, that is OR and AND to be executed. We have something called De Morgan's law. It states that NOT of A and NOT of B is always equivalent to NOT of A or B. How we can prove is, we can prove this by putting a truth table, by putting in a form of table. It says that, it says NOT A and NOT B is always equivalent to NOT of A or B. This is a De Morgan's law. Now how we can prove this is true? We can prove this by putting in a form of table, in a form of truth table. We write A and B, NOT A and NOT B, and we write this, the first statement. So we write A, B, NOT A and NOT B, and we write this, the whole, NOT A and NOT B, this one. Okay, and we take the result. For example, for A and B, it can be true true, it can be true false, or it can be false true, or it can be false false. Okay. In this fashion you can write, or you can write in a fashion of first one, true true false false, true false true false. Okay, both are same. Now if you say that A is true, not of A is
false.
So it is true, it is false. Then false, true, false, true. Then not of B. What is not of B?
False, true.
False, true.
False, true.
False, true. Okay. Then after that we need to do not A and not B. So not A is this one, not B is this one. And we need to do AND. In the AND, if both are false.
False.
False. If false, true.
False.
True, false.
False.
And true, true.
True.
This is what? A, not A and not B. So the result, this is, result is this one. Now we try to calculate this one. Not of A or B. So we put another truth table. Another truth table. We say A, B, A or B, and not of
A or B.
So A true true false false, true false true false. Now A or B, true or true?
True.
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 False true is true, false, false
false,
not of it, false false
false
true. So you see the value of this one, false, three false and one true, and you have the value of this one, false 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 and one true, both are same, hence they are equal. This is how you will prove it. In the exam, they will give you two statements, okay, like this, two statements, and ask you to check both are equal or not. So how do you prove, or how do you check?
Can you get A, B, A?
Yeah, you can get A, B, C, three propositions, or you can get two propositions. Three propositions you can handle with eight different options, for or three, eight different values. For example, if you have A, B, C, see, it is always 2 to the power of number of propositions. When we have 2, A and B, it is 2 power 2, 4. So you have 4 different propositions, true, true, false, false, and true, false, true, false. These 4 different propositions. If you have 3, A, B, C, it is 2 power 3, that is, how much, 2 power 3? 8. So you should have an 8th propositions here. So how it can be 8 propositions is that you put A, B and C. A, B and C. Okay. you write 4 true, 4 false, that is half true, half false. And then you repeat 2 true and 2 false. And then you repeat 1 true and 1 false. Now you see different, all are different. This is all true, this is 2 true, 1 false, true, false, true. True, false, 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 true, true, false, true, false, 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 true, and totally false. And then you can do A or B, A or B or C, and so on. You can do it if you want. For example, if you want to do A or B or C. So first you do A or B, and then you do or C. Okay? So for example, we'll do A or B. So first you calculate A or B. 2, true. It is true. And this is true, true. Again, it is true. True, false, true. True, false, true. False, true. False, true. False, false. And false. Now, if you want to do C along with this, so you write A or B, you have this one, or C. So that is you are going to do or with these two. So true, true is again, it is true. False, true, true. True. True and one false. So like this you can do. You can do or and not. Okay. This is called truth table. Fine. This is the De Morgan's law given here. Not A and not B is always equal to not A, not of A or B. You check the values. Both are same, hence they are equal. Not A or not B is always equal to not of A and B. You can also put the truth table and see their values. Both are same, hence they are equal. Fine. So this is all what you have in this unit number 6. Okay. So you have this unit number 6, up to unit number 6 for your midterm exam. But he's telling it is up to unit number 3. You saw it. Okay, you go and double check it. Please go and double check it. That because today I saw in the central LMS that it is up to unit number 6. Okay, whereas usually it is up to unit number 6, 1, 2, 3, and unit number 6.
I saw
unit number 6. Yeah, fine. This is all what we have for unit number 3. As a summary, what we understand in the unit number 6 is that about the computer structure, hardware and software, different programming languages, and what we saw today, that programming structure, sequential or conditional and repetition. Okay, we saw some flowchart, trace table, and the truth tables. The Boolean operators not and or, three operators. Okay, so you'll have problem solving questions from this about the flowchart and trace table and this De Morgan's law. Okay, as a problem solving in this, the midterm exam will have three parts. Part 1 multiple choice, part 2 will be essay questions, that is about definitions and the characteristics and all, and part 3 about problem solving. Yeah, you have the flow chart and the truth tables and all. Number conversions, base 2 to base 8, that is binary to octal and octal to decimal.
Yes,
you have the number conversions.
Okay.
See, if there is a conversion from binary to octal, first you convert binary to decimal and then decimal to octal. Okay? No, the exam is on Monday. You have the timetable. The exam is on Monday, 20th November, not on Wednesday. At 3 p.m. Yeah. You have the timetable on LMS. Go back and check the LMS. Okay? Fine. So this is all what we have for you for today.